So hello students, welcome to the module number 1. We are going to discuss further topic that is under mechanical behavior chapter. So after once you understood the concept of ductile and brittle material, so that what will be the linear, non-linear, elastic behavior and properties we'll discuss. So in this brittle material, from the concept of brittle material we'll discuss, the cast iron or glass or concrete or ceramic material all are comes under this brittle material, and which is characterized by the fact that fracture occurs without any noticeable change in the rate of elongation. For a gray cast iron material, it will be a different figure. So because it shows the graph is different from along stress versus strain. So that depends upon the rate of elongation. Okay, so it's clear that from this concept, there is no yield point at all and no necking takes place. Hence, this ultimate point and fracture point are same. So the material does not exhibit any ductility, and one of the failure characteristics of brittle material is that the two broken parts can be reassembled to produce the same shape and original component, as there will be not be a neck formation in case of ductile material. So that in detail will what is the neck formation, how it will be a fracture risk failure will discuss. So these are all the things in the coming chapter will be there, the creep, fatigue and all. So there are different steps or to get the formation of neck and neck formation of the material. Okay, so now we will discuss about the different stress strain curve or linear non-linear elastic behavior on the graph. Okay. So this linear and non-linear elastic behavior and properties. So we can see this brittle material. The material is also a strong because of there is a little strain for a high stress. The fracture of a brittle material sudden with the little or no plastic deformation. So glass as an example. So if you take a blue color here. So I am explaining this. So this linear curve, this is a linear curve. There is no curve at all. Simply, it will, if you take the load on this material, like example glass you take, the stress is a strain. So what happened? As stress increases, means the load increases, there is no deformation at all. Finally, it will be take the load and finally it will be broken. So it will be break. So that is what the example for the brittle material. So that will be a linear curve, if we can see. So whereas for the strong material which is having not ductile, that is example in brittle itself, some materials having some with such a very strong material compared to glass, so it will be a deformation take place and it will be broke very after certain curve. See, you can see from here it will be deformation taking place and little curve, and then it will be failure. And if it is, if you take ductile material example, there is a non-linear curve, so stress strain curve, there is a elastic region will be there, and duct yield point will be there, so and plastic region will be there. All these will be a non-linear kind of things. So okay, so this is about the non-linear kind of properties. So okay, and certain plastic material you take vary with small elastic region, so it will take a very less load and it will be a fracture. So this is how the material are behave at various stress and strain curve for linear and non-linear elastic behavior. And the properties are already we discussed for the ductile and brittle, so the same property will be there. So only the thing is that we have to observe after the taking the load of that material, it will be at what point it will be break, so that we have to identify. So this is about the stress strain curve for the different material. Okay, so let us will discuss further topics in the next slide. Thank you. Thanks for watching.